Hey Rat Gang, it's your boy Marquer. I'm back for another video. I bet I know exactly what you're thinking right now. Yo, what? You just uploaded like 3 days ago. What are you doing here? Well, due to my weird ass posting schedule that no one will ever understand, I have to post today. So here I am. Hi, I'm Maddie or Marquer. So today I did another Marquer illustration. I really don't like using the word illustration, but I don't want to say doodle or drawing because it sounds sort of unprofessional and unput together. But 2 weeks ago, I was just going through TikTok like you do, and I saw a ton of these girls all at once, like in my For You page, like one after another of videos, and they all looked exactly like this. So, you know, I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna draw a mixture of all of them. And so here they all are in their greatest glory and everything, wonderfulness, awesome. So in case you hadn't realized in the clip I'm showing right now, I actually accidentally cut out a big old part of the first part of me doing the skin. It was just me doing the bottom half of the face, and I missed a little bit of the cheeks and a little bit of the lips, but that's about it. It's not really that big of a deal, but I still wanted to apologize because that probably annoys some people, as it does me. I mentioned earlier the TikTok thing, but I think this is also a sort of Instagram baddie kind of thing. And if you don't know what an Instagram baddie is, it's basically like badass chick on Instagram, or like an Instagram model sort of thing. And so I totally thought she looks like an Instagram baddie, and she's so cute. I love her so much. Like, I love her little clips, and I love her long dark hair. My aesthetic is long dark hair, honestly. And she's just, I love the way she looks. Very cute. In fact, I actually like this drawing so much that it is currently the profile photo on all of my social medias, almost. So that's pretty cool. Now to wrap up this voiceover, I'm going to tell you some of the materials I use, because most of the time I just use like I use my Copic markers, some kind of fine liner, and then a pencil. But today I used actually this different pen. I think it's a Artline like brush marker Lego pen, and it's super cool. I really like it, and it's water-based ink, so it kind of slid off the paper a little because I use Ultra Smooth Bristol, in case you didn't know, which is by Strathmore, and I use the heaviest poundage that they possibly have. I don't know it off the top of my head, but you get the idea. And then I also used my Copic markers on this. And then I also used, I think I used my Sharpies in there too. And I also used my water-based watercolor brush pens, which I barely ever use. I use them for like brush pen line art sometimes. Like I use them in the Saturation Nation video and Least Saturated Colors video. And so then I also used my Ohu alcohol based markers, and my these are the ones with the bullet nibs that I own, and the bullet nib ones are extremely old. Like, they're so old. Like, I think I got them in like fall 2016, and as of recording this, it's like August 2019, so I've had them for quite a while. And in case you didn't know, alcohol markers sometimes don't last very long, especially if you use them constantly. And at the time of me getting these, they were like the only art supply I used. So I used most of them. So now I'm kind of left with those weird colors I never really use. So I'm trying to incorporate them as much as I can into my art, because I don't want them to just go to waste. It's, well, a waste. And then I also used just random pens from my drawer that I found. So I have a few miscellaneous bags of stuff in my drawer, and I went into two of my miscellaneous bags and just grabbed out random pens and stuff, and I started using those too. So yeah.
And then also, I did something that I saw a Instagram artist I follow do. She enhances the blush a little bit with a red colored pencil. So I decided I would try that. So I used a Crayola colored pencil for that. I also, for the first time ever, I bought an eraser. That sounds really weird. Let me explain. So my whole life, I have just used like random erasers that I found. I've never actually like bought a nice eraser, and it's not even a nice eraser. I straight up got it from Dollar Tree, but for some reason I value it so much and it works so well because I've only for like the last like year now been using the Koi Noor ones, the kneadable erasers, and those can't get quite as deep into and get out the pigment out of the paper quite as the just normal like Palmer erasers can. So I really like this new Palmer eraser. It's just the most basic eraser ever, but I just love it. And it's better than the pink erasers that you use in like schoolwork and stuff because it doesn't leave the pink smudge. And so I love it. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe to me, Marquer. I also have quite a few different socials too, which will be somewhere around there. You can check the description for those because there's so many. And if you like the music in this video, that's also in the description. I also have a playlist with all the music I've ever used in my videos in it. So if you want to check that out too, go ahead and listen to it. They're pretty nice music. Anyway, that was it for today's video. I'm going to go finish editing this and then make the thumbnail. And so I gotta go. Thank you for watching, and later.
Stop loving you, bitch. Keep crying. Catch a nigga slipping from behind. Boom.